the grace. Good Lord, I'm saved by the grace of God. I am saved. Glory, glory, Lord, hallelujah. Yes, by the grace of God, I am saved. Thank you, Jesus. I have been walking hand in hand with my Jesus. You know that I'm saved. Yes, Lord. I have been walking, yes, with Jesus. You know that I'm saved.
Jesus, yes, Lord. Just come and people of God. We are here, praise God, for the ongoing service. Praise God of Philip Fagan. Praise God. God has blessed him with long life. As Psalms 91, last verse, with long life shall I satisfy him and show him my salvation. We'd like to have somebody closing passage for us, please. Could somebody close? Shall he live, and whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand at the latter day upon this earth. And though after my skin worm destroy this body, yet in my flesh shall I see God, whom I shall see for myself, and mine eyes shall behold, and not another. We brought nothing into this world, and it is certain we can carry nothing out. The Lord gave, and the Lord take it away. Blessed is the name of the Lord. We now turn to our moderator, Pastor Robert Taylor, in Jesus' name.
Let us worship the Lord. Let us give honor to God.
Bless the Lord.
Hallelujah. Praise his holy name.
Hallelujah.
Our God is awesome.
Amen.
Our God is marvelous.
Amen.
And our God is wonderful.
Hallelujah.
Our God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. And the psalmist repeated again in verse 11, said, the Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Shall we worship the Lord? Shall we praise the Lord? Shall we magnify the Lord? Glory to his name. Our God is awesome. He's wonderful and he's marvelous. And today I greet you in the precious name of Jesus Christ and welcome you to this Thanksgiving and celebration service of the life of James Fagan. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. We are here to worship God. We are here to rejoice. I know this occasion at times seems to be sad, but you know what Papa would say? He would say, don't cry. He would say, don't worry. He would say, rejoice. He would say, my soul is all right. So no need to worry, no need to fret, because my soul is all right with God. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise his holy name. So we're going to rejoice this morning. We're going to rejoice in the God of our salvation for the long, long, long life. of Elder James Fagan. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise his holy name. Praise God. And so I welcome all of you. Though tears might be in their eyes, but let it be tears of joy. Let it be tears of rejoicing. Yes, we're going to miss him. Yes, we're going to want to see him again. We're not going to hear those things they used to say to us, but we can relive them in our memories. Praise the name of the Lord, because memories last forever. And today we're here to celebrate his life. Papa was a husband, a father, a grandfather, a great-grandfather, a great-great-grandfather. He was a brother, an uncle, cousin, friend. Most of all, he was a child of the living God. Somebody had to praise God for that. Somebody had to worship God for that. Praise the name of the Lord. He was a servant of the true and living God. And for that, I am grateful. He has set examples for every one of us. Every one of us in here. And if we should lose our soul, it's nobody's fault but ours. Because he has lived a life. And he was not a hypocrite. He lived a life. He taught the life. He walked the life. That was Elder James Fagan. Praise the name of the Lord. And as we continue, I'm sure there will be many things to say. And so I'm not going to say much for now. But as the Spirit lead, praise the name of the Lord. Praise his holy name. And now we're going to stand. We're going to start with the hymn, "It Is Well With My Soul." And we're going to sing to the glory, honor, and praise of Almighty God.
When peace
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We worship the Lord. We magnify you, Lord. Glory be to his name. It is well with his soul. Somebody praise the Lord up in here. Somebody worship the Lord up in here. Oh, glory be to his name. At this time, we're going to have opening prayer by Minister White. Name of Jesus.
Bless the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everyone. Bless the Lord, everyone.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Just bow your head with me and cry. Almighty God and our Father who are in heaven, we thank you again, Lord, for this another day that thou art made and hallowed it so we come perfect day before man. So as we stand, O God, with agreement with your word today, Lord, and giving thanks unto you for all of your favor and your wonderful work that you've done among us. And O God, as we come today, we want to worship you in spirit and in truth. Hallelujah. So many today, O God, they are grieved over their loved one. Some are feel missing place inside, Lord, because they miss their dear friend. But Jesus, you are our comforter, and you promise we that you will comfort me throughout all our tribulation that we're going through. That's why today, Lord, we come and say thanks to you for your many, hallelujah, blessing that you provide upon your children. As your people gather here today, oh God, to put away, hallelujah, the lost piece of, hallelujah, some father and some grandfather and some great-great-grandfather, some friend and some brother. I pray to give us strength to carry on. I pray, Lord, that you send forth anointing in this service today. Lord, do not leave us, O God, or forsake us, O God, because of sin. But I pray today that you will forgive us our sin and our trespasses. That as we stand before you, O God, we will ask of your will and it shall be done among us. Bless this service today. Lead it to complete victory. Let a soul be cry out in this house today that they heal, they cannot bear it no longer. Oh God, as we are putting away, oh God, our spiritual father, let a new one born for your kingdom in this house today, Lord God. That as our eye turn towards the heaven today, we'll know that God, hallelujah, provide for us one more time. Bless and take over the service today. Let your will be done among us. And remember, oh God, the activity of this day. I pray that you strengthen each and every one to the activity that they must do. And oh God, that as we go on, we will worship you in spirit and truth. Bless this service as I ask this mercy in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.
Thank God for Minister White as he interceded on our behalf. As we get ready for the first scripture reading, I take time out to greet our dear Bishop Thomas, all the ministers on the platforms, all the saints of God. I greet you in the precious name of Jesus Christ. To the bereaved family, as we bereaved, let us know that God is our present help. Amen. And so as we continue with the service, let us remember him in all that he has done and all that he has lived. Bless the name of the Lord. And so our first scripture reading is coming to us from 1 Corinthians 15, verses 51 to 58, and it will be read by Dennis Richards' granddaughter.
Behold, I assure you a mystery. We shall not all sleep. We shall all be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is in the law. But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as ye know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord.
Amen. Amen. The reading of the word of God. And the church say?
Amen.
Amen. Praise his holy name. And at this time, we're going to have the Refuge Temple Apostolic Church, who is going to come to us and sing some of Elder Fagan's favorite songs. The Apostolic Refuge Temple Apostolic Church. Amen. Let's have them. As we remember Elder Fagan with these songs, some of his favorite songs. And if we should sing all of them, we would be here all day. Amen. Amen? And so we're not going to sing all, but they're going to do their best.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
This afternoon, we want to give God thanks for the life of Elder Fagan. Elder Fagan was a dedicated man of God. He was a worshiper. Saints, there is never a dull moment with Elder Fagan. And he was a singer. He always said that God must be praised. From the rising of the sun and to the going down of the same. So there was never a dull moment. So when you come to church and you don't come to worship, Brother Fagan, he said he doesn't play church. If he's going to play church, he goes to your home. When he come to church, he come to worship. And this afternoon, we want to sing a few of his favorite songs. We wish you could sing like him, but praise God. What is man? What is man? What is man? What is man? Man is like a baby rose. In the morning you fresh and in the evening you wither away. Man is like a baby rose. What is man?
Bye. Glory! Glory to God! Hallelujah! Don't be grieving! But I am leaving! Oh, glory to God! Glory to God! Glory to God! Praise His holy name! Hallelujah! Praise His holy name! Oh, the Spirit of God is in this place. Oh, yes. It's a day of rejoicing. It's a day of rejoicing. A day of celebration. And when we are celebrating, we don't usually cry. But we stand on our feet at times. And we jump at times. And we dance at times. And we shout. Because this is a celebration service. Oh, glory be to God. Praise His holy name. Praise God. And as they were singing this song, I was remembering Papa sitting in that chair right over there. And we didn't have electricity back in those days. Papa was the only one who has a microphone. Even though we didn't have no electricity, he has a microphone. Because when he make his fist and he put it to his mouth, and he's holding his head like this. And when he began to sing, oh, glory to God.
Hallelujah.
I remember people used to run and leave their dinner on fire, leave their dinner on the fire to come and listen to Papa preach. So don't be grieving today. Because Papa life is well.
Hallelujah.
He is.
Hallelujah.
He has lived a good life. And his life is well. Praise His holy name. Blessed be His name. Glory to God. Glory to God. Praise God. Thank God. And we're going to go into the second scripture reading now. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise His holy name. The second scripture reading is coming from 1 Thessalonians 4, verse 13 through 18. It will be done by Chantel Atkins, great-granddaughter. Let's have her. Praise His holy name. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. Praise His holy name. Amen. Amen. Praise Him. Glory to God. Worship. Jesus, Jesus. Glory, glory, glory.
Morning, everyone. We'll be reading Thessalonians 4, verse 13 to 18. But I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that ye sorrow not even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with Him. For this we say unto you, by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord Himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise again. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words. Let us say amen.
Amen. The word of the living God. Let's honor it by everyone saying amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Chantel. And we're moving on. We're going to have a special selection by Jean Johnson, great-granddaughter. Is Jean Johnson here?
Yes.
Great-granddaughter. Everyone has a program, so just follow the program because we're going to move real quickly to get this through. Amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Where is her?
Bless the Lord. Greetings to everyone. I greet you well in the mighty name of Jesus. Now we'll sing this song. Blessed Assurance, Jesus is mine, from the hymn now.
Blessed Assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Here of salvation, purchase of God, born of His Spirit.
This is my story. This is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. Praise the name of the Lord. Thank you for serving all the days of my life. And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Thank you. Amen. Well done. Amen. Praise God. Thank God for you, Romaine. Beautiful. Well done. And truthful. Amen. Amen. That there are things that are well written, well spoken, but are not true. But this we could say is well written, well spoken, and is well true. Praise the name of the Lord. Oh, praise God. Give the Lord a praise. Give the Lord a praise. Give him a praise. Worship the Lord. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. Sister Barbara Facey, family friend, are you ready? Oh, yes, she's ready. Amen. After which we're going to have Deacon Fitzroy Edwards, family friend. So prepare yourself.
Shall we worship the Lord? Let's worship the Lord. Let's worship the Lord. Praise God forever. It's a pleasure being here. I must greet my worthy pastor, Mr. Chairman. I just want to greet you all this morning, the wonderful family, the Fagans family, humble and wonderful. Praise be to God. I just want to greet you all in the mighty name of Jesus. All my friends and well-wishers, I greet you in the wonderful name of Jesus. You know, sometimes when you said you sit here and everybody saying, you know, when you go to some funeral, people have to take stick and a push up and a find search for word or whatever. When the person not even deserve half of it. Amen. Bless the name of Jesus. We could have said amen and go, amen. Because everybody said the same truth, the fact about Brother James. Amen. Praise God forever. Amen. You know, I've been a friend for the family, of the family for so long. And I do not regret a minute of it. I was saying to somebody that Monica, that's we call her Tip then. We were friends from school days. And until this minute, one of you never, nobody ever hear me and Monica say fast to each other. We live in unity. And I think, you know, many things that going on nowadays, it costs to parent. When parents sow a good seed in their children's heart, they grow up with it. Praise God. Some other principle out of road still. But many things that go on, it costs from home. It leave from home. Praise be to God. Had it not been the way Monica grew up and myself grew up, praise be to God, probably it would be otherwise. But praise God forever. Bless the name of Jesus. I'm happy this afternoon I can stand here. Praise be to God and stand tall. Because Brother James had... I can remember the last time I see Brother James. I know many of us talk and there is space for many more, so we have to cut short. You know, I can remember the last time I visited Brother James. You never meet Brother James, go to Brother James, and he don't give you a scripture or pray with you. Praise be to God. And not only you of yourself, but he's inquiring about your children. My first daughter named Miss Ken, and he would always ask, how's Sir Ken? Give Sir Ken this chapter for me. Tell her to read Psalm 91. And if I go to Brother James 10 times, he tell me to tell Sir Ken to read Psalm 91. Bless the name of Jesus. The last time I visited him, though he has been blind, but Bridget, let me tell you something. He knows everything. And in his sense, still intact. Praise God forever. He no miss nothing. And when Brother James talk, and we pray together. And you know, I was ready to go. He said, yo, no matter, did it? Get up, so I'm out. Me say, Brother James, me come to visit you. Me no, you no bother with that man. And Brother James, he insist that you will give me a Malta. Okay, Bridget, it pays to serve the Lord. It pays to live a sober life. You know, many times we take foolishness and as doom his soul to hell. Praise be to God. And if you only reflect on Brother James' life, if you only reflect on way back when, praise be to God, when this man used to be calling his revival service, and as his son said, people won't left their food. Food not sweet when Brother James Bond's ready. Praise God forever. No food not sweet. Because as you rightly said, Brother James is the first man that used a microphone. Praise God forever. His microphone all, you know, it reflect me of the song that says, essential, never busy. Brother James always ready. Praise God forever. Bridging this man. This man, the remain of him that is here, praise be to God, he set good record. Yes. And if any of his children go otherwise, our grandchildren go otherwise, it's not Brother James' fault. It's not Sister Birdie that gone on before fault. Praise God forever. Virgin, let us live a life. Let us live a life to sing about in our soul. Praise God, I can remember the last time he said he wanted to come to our church. And what he insists that one of his sons take him there. And when Brother James come out, we say, Brother James, you have to say something. He said, yes, I want to say something. And he give us his word. And he sing his song. What is man? What is man? What is man? What is man? Man is like a fading flowers in the morning, you fresh and green. In the evening, you wither away. Man is like a fading flowers. Let us examine ourselves. Let us look around. Let us look in our mirror and see how we look now. But in the morning, we shall wither away. God bless you, Jesus.
Continue to bless God.
Bless the Lord. Continue to worship the Lord. Thank you, Sister Facy. And all what has been said are all true. Amen?
Amen.
And we are so grateful to God for allowing him to live such a life, to leave such a legacy, to leave such examples that we can follow.
Amen.
Into the kingdom of God.
Hallelujah. I'm not sorry I've answered the Master's call. Oh, Jesus, too. Come on, let's have church.
Sorry that they have answered to the master's call. Now it's up to you to answer to the master's call. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. He's not hearing anything we're saying today. So everything that's been done today is for us, for you and for me, to get our life right with God, to live a life that is pleasing in God, so that when the time comes and we lay like this, our soul will be with God. Because it is appointed unto man once to die, and after death comes the judgment. No man can escape that judgment. So let us live right. Deacon Edwards. Let's have Deacon Edwards. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise God.
Let us praise the Lord.
Praise
Let us worship the Lord.
Praise
the name of Jesus. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The writer said, blessed are they that die in the Lord.
Yes.
For they cease from their labor and their work do follow them.
Amen.
Praise the name of the Lord. I'm so glad this afternoon to stand here to say a few words. On the behalf of my dear friend, Pastor Taylor, I met Brother Fagan some years ago. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And I do feel blessed to have known him for myself. Praise the name of the Lord. Because this man, truly, he was a blessing. Every time I visit, he always some words of consolation, some words of hope. And today Brother Fagan is resting. He's free from this tile and this snare, and he's resting in the name of Jesus. And I just want to close off with this song. Blessed be the name of the Lord. So long I've searched for life's meaning, enslaved by the world and my greed. Then the door of my prison was opened by love, and the ransom was paid. I'm free. I'm free from the cares of tomorrow. I am free from the
reflection by Brother Pinnock.
From the dark empty life I'm set free.
I must say, just before Brother Fagan went home, I happened to see him and happened to pray with him and sing with him.
Yes.
And praise the name of Jesus. He was resting in the arms of the Savior. God bless you in Jesus' name.
Man, bless the Lord. Thank you, Deacon Edwards. Such a beautiful song. I am free from the cares of tomorrow. I am free from the guilt of. I have traded my shackles for a. And praise the Lord. I am free. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Papa is free from the cares of tomorrow. He's free from the worries of tomorrow. He's free from the sicknesses and diseases of tomorrow. He has traded the shackles. Glory to God. Hallelujah. He has traded the shackles. Hallelujah. For a glorious crown. Praise the Lord. He's free today. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And it's important also to know that you can trade your shackles. Doesn't matter what the shackles are. You can trade them for a glorious crown. Praise the name of the Lord. He has fought a good fight. He has kept the faith. He has finished his course. Hallelujah. He has finished his course. And now he's laid up a crown of righteousness for him. And not for him only, but for everyone who will love his appearing. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise God. We're going to have another selection by the Thompson family. Family we grew up with. Amen. Live next to each other. We could call and talk to each other. Amen. Praise God. Welcome the Thompson family. In Jesus' name.
I wonder what I
for such beautiful song. Praise the name of the Lord. And we grew up together. We used to live over there, and they live over here. And I remember one time we wanted to leave the house, but Papa then would not let us leave the house. So we would call and act as if we're talking to them, and we're asking them questions, and we're answering to ourselves as if we are speaking to them. And we would say, dial our vinette. Papa don't want us to leave the house, but we weren't actually talking to them. And we were there communicating with ourselves as if we had talked to them, but Papa would just sit there and he's smiling at us, knowing much better than us, wise man. And he's just there watching us doing our foolishness. And then he would say, "Pissing tail boy, you took me a fool." Right? That's the Papa we started talking about here. Amen? Thank you for such wonderful selection. Praise the name of the Lord. Now this time we're going to have a reflection. We're going to have one by Thelma Hennis and then Joy Stevenson. But I believe Thelma is not here, so we're going to have his grandson read. His grandson take his place.
His cousin.
No, Papa grandson.
Let's praise the Lord, saints. Let's praise the Lord. This church is a Holy Ghost church. It's my auntie husband. May I be in this church. And I am living for God. No matter how you see me, I am living for God. And for because I prove God for myself. Last year at that time, I was on the rough side of the mountain. And here I am this moment, call upon the true and living God. For God has been so good to me. Yesterday evening, I was walking. And suppose I was walking, my foot just turned over like this. And it's praying. And I was crying whole night last night. And I say, I want to come on my real, real auntie husband. For that man is my favorite man. I say, I want to come. And last night, whole night I cried. Pain. And I said, God, I buy my ticket and I cannot come. No. Debbie, you lose. You cancer. God cancer that. You can't win me. Me say, God, me are your daughter. And you can't make the Debbie overcome me. I'm go up on my knee upon the bed and start pee blood upon my foot. And say, God, I have to come on my favorite uncle funeral. For that man was a father to me. That man was loved me so much. No matter when I went up there, and no matter how when I eat, he always have a piece of dumpling at the side and tell my auntie, say, this are for me. And when me I go through my rough time last year, that man was praying for me. He never leave me alone. So I couldn't hop and come to his funeral. And I said, Deborah, you is a liar from the pit of hell. And last night when I was talking to God, in Psalms 23, come and say, verse 4. The Lord, they say, no, not all of it, the 4. Say, though I walk through the valley of the shadows of death, I shall fear no evil. And when I start to say that, I just start feeling the power of God. And I say, God, I have to hop to come to my auntie husband's funeral. For I love that man so much. For I love me. This when I over there, and him up here, I keep fasting, I can't keep my heel. Not every heat I can eat. When I tell my husband, say, hear my uncle then. Right? I can't keep my heel. So to God be the glory. Great things he have done. If you don't see me, you don't pray for me. And if you don't see me, you don't pray for me. For because I'm determined to hold on. No matter what people want to say about me. God know the inside of me. And I am living a clean life for God. I am living for God. For not for we. And we not thief. And we not robber. We not thief. And we not coming in my fornication, but the least in the little word send me straight in a hell. So we must be careful of what the word will come out of your mouth against your brother and sister. I'm so glad I am not the girl where I used to be. I am not the girl where I used to be. I am so glad, and I'm glad for my uncle, for encouraging me. He encouraged me. This is the church where I used to come when I live over there. But you know, to be young, we fall. But I tell God, say, this time I am not falling. I am living a clean life before God. I am not here. I am overseas. But all of you do pray for me, for because I am determined to hold on to the hand. And I want to sing this little chorus. Your grace and mercy brought me to. I'm living.
My brother, Thelma's cousin.
Hello, everyone.
Hello.
Unfortunately, Marcia Annis, to many, Thelma could not make it today. So in her absence, she asked that I read this special tribute.
Praise God.
Amen?
Amen.
James Fagan, also known as James Red. When I read this first sentence, I had to reread it many times. I called her to find out if this was his name back then. I even asked my mom, my uncles to confirm, and they all did. So let me start over. James Fagan, also known as James Red. They say he is gone too soon, but no. I say he is gone at the right time. And I know he is in a place of rest with his eternal Father. Mr. Fagan was a true revival man. Caring and always encouraging. He was a joy to be around. I remember he used to preach, and everyone who would draw near to listen. He was always so happy. Happy at home, happy at church, happy everywhere he went. I know he lived his life to the fullest, being blessed to live to a milestone age of 104 years. A milestone many of us may not get the opportunity to see. I have so many fond memories of him. I can remember growing up as a child. He was my father figure, and even sometimes a mother. He was the first person to show me love and what love looked like in the things he did and said. I would watch him as a child accompany his children to catch water outside. Because they were too scared to go alone or bring in food from the rain, as his children were afraid of the mud. Though I wasn't his child, he never once made me feel like an outsider, and he never scolded me. Instead, he showed me through his actions how to behave and live a life in Christ. And when he became a grandfather, I watched him give the same love to his grandchildren. As a man of God, he always tried to instill God's teaching, emphasizes that we adhere to God's word. Parents should grow their children to know the Lord, and children should learn to be obedient. I remember his last words to me were, "Did you give your heart to the Lord yet? You must give your heart to the Lord and get married." Oh, how I wish I could be there to see him off. But I know, for if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with them. 1 Thessalonians 4:14. Amen?
Amen?
And again, this is from Marcia Ennis, to many known as Tama. Amen?
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 Amen.
Praise the Lord. Amen?
Hallelujah.
Thank you. And this is coming from, of course, Marcia Ennis, which has been read by my brother, Will Nash Williams. Amen?
Amen.
True words of God. No papa, no nonsense person.
Amen.
Amen. And as the City of Faith Church of God get ready to come, I just want to share a little thing about Papa. You know, it's the wrong thing to put a grandson up here that lived with him for all those years. Because if I should start talking, none of you would get any time to say anything. But I'm not going to be selfish. But Papa was a no-nonsense person.
Amen.
He was not a hypocrite. And what he says is what he means. And I can remember, I think about a few years ago, I was here, and it was the night, and my uncle that lived with him brought someone to the house. Right? And it was too late. I said, I don't know where the person lives, so I'm not going to drive in the dark at that time to take the person home. And Papa get up out of his bed, put the young lady in his bed, and he went into the living room, and he brought my uncle into the living room with him. And he turned the couch to block the door. And he sit up in the couch all night. And you know Papa was blind, right? And when I wake up in the morning, Papa said, "Renford, I will watch them all night." I busted out a laugh because I'm thinking this man is blind. And he said, "I will watch them all night." But there was only one way to get in there. And he sit there and he blocked the way so he could not pass to go in the room. And what do you think Papa did the first day when he come to church on Sunday? And say, "May I go talk before we're not here?" And he get up and he said it. Yes, he explained everything what happened. He said, "Nothing happened because I watched them the whole night." Praise the name of the Lord. That's the Papa we serve. I mean, that's the Papa that we know. Praise the name of the Lord. A true man of God. A no-nonsense man of God. And it doesn't matter who you are, he's going to speak the truth. He doesn't hide it. He doesn't go around the corner and come around. He's going to bring it straight to you. Praise the name of the Lord. Sometimes it hurt, but he's going to speak it. That's our grandfather we're talking about. Amen? That's Elder James Fagan. Praise the name of the Lord. And so we have City of Faith, Church of God, is going to come to us. Amen? Let's have them. As they come, I want to welcome Pastor Murray in our midst, all the way from Massachusetts here with us today. Pastor Murray, thank God for being here. I also want to welcome Reverend Brown from the New Testament Church of God, Seventh Day. We welcome you, the New Testament Church of God, we welcome you into the house of God today. Amen?
Amen.
Bless the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise God.
God.
have dreamed of a city called glory.
Worship the Lord for such beautiful rendition.
Hallelujah.
I sing glory to the Son of God. Thank you, City of Faith Church of God, for this selection. And we're moving right along. Time is going. So at this time, we're going to have a presentation to the church by Patmore's Funeral Home. Are you ready? Patmore's Funeral Home. Alright, so I'll read what they've given. Okay. Alright, and so here Patmore Funeral Home is saying thank you for the continuous support to the community. Let me restart again. In saying thank you for the continuous support to the community, Patmore's Funeral Home would like to make a donation to the Refuge Temple Apostolic Church towards their outreach. And enclosed in this envelope is an offering that Patmore's Funeral Home has given to the Refuge Temple Apostolic Church of God. Give the Lord praise for that. Give the Lord praise for that. Praise His holy name. And at this time, before we go any further, we're going to collect an offering for the church. And so we're asking you to get ready as we sing this song, and the offering will be collected.
We shall have a new name in that land, in that land, that sunny, sunny land. We shall have a new name in that land, in that sunny land. We shall have a new name, precious name, in that sunny land. We shall have a new name, precious name.
We'll be right back.
Lord Jesus. Praise God. Please stand for the blessing of God. Mighty God, we want to thank you, Almighty God, for this offering that has been collected. I pray that we'll open the windows of heaven and pour out a blessing upon it, that there will not be room enough to receive it. Bless and sanctify it in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Thank you for your giving. God will bless you abundantly. Amen?
Amen.
Praise God. And I forgot to welcome our Elder Taylor here on the rostrum with me. Amen? Yes, same name as me. That means we are related. Right? Yes, we are related. Elder Taylor, welcome in the name of Jesus. Praise the name of the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. And at this time, we're going to have... is the MP here? All right, so we're going to have Sister Facey come to us on behalf of the MP.
Praise the Lord. Good afternoon again, everyone. Praise the Lord. Member of Parliament, Mr. Xavier Maid, who regrettably absent today, has asked me to deliver this tribute on his behalf. I have been hearing about the Fagans family from a long time until I was blessed to meet him in person sometimes last year. At that time, he was 103. He has lost his vision, yes, but friends, his strong belief in God was not missing. I can imagine how strong he was when he was a young man. To the member of the bereaved family, Brother James has left a godly legacy.
Amen.
He set an example. Keep it up. Share the love. Share the peace. Share the unity. Live as he wants everyone to live a godly life. Brother, a godly life so we can meet him at the bank of the beautiful river. God bless you all richly. MP Xavier Maine. And in the same breath, I would like to say condolence to the Fagans family from Moffett, otherwise known as Miss Thompson. God bless you.
Thank you, Sister Facey. Thank the MP for such remarks. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. And yes, I remember last year, because his photo was in the Observer, right?
Yes.
Yes, and I saw it 103 years old. And this year, 104 years old. And you know one thing? Every time we come and we leave, Papa would say, you're not gonna come back and see me again. He's been saying this from 1987, 89, every time he's been saying this. But you know what hit me after he passed that I didn't realize? Last year, August, when I was here, and when I left, he never said it. He never said it, that I'm not gonna see him when I come back. He didn't say it, but it never registered until after he passed. And so I believe and I know that he has lived a good life. And all that you are hearing today are facts of life. Amen?
Amen.
Praise his own name. At this time, we are going to have a selection by Sister Carlin Richards, granddaughter, and also my fiery sister, as she come and sing to the glory and honor of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Continue to bless the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Come on, Grandpa would want you to be livelier than that. Continue to bless the Lord. One more time, bless the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen, amen. Hallelujah. Amen.
So for the person running Zoom, I received word that you kept going in and out, so if you could look into that, please. Hallelujah. If I walk in the pathway of duty, hallelujah. If I work to the close of the day, hallelujah, I shall see the great King in His beauty. Oh, when I'm on the last mile of the way, can I sing that again? If I walked like my grandpa walked in the line of duty, Holy Ghost. Hey, God! If I work to the close of the day, oh Lord, I shall see the great King in His beauty. Oh, when I'm gone, show me His glory. Hallelujah. Oh,
Like this. When you are laying in the grave, what will people be saying about you? And the most important thing is, what will God be saying about you? When you have reached the last mile of the way, when you have get to the end of that journey, where you can no longer do anything about it, you cannot talk anymore, you cannot praise God anymore, you cannot say, Lord, forgive me anymore. When you get to that last mile of the way, what will it be? Will your life be hidden in God? Or will your life be hidden with the enemy? And that is why we have to live like Papa lived. We have to live according to the word of God. So that when we get to the last mile of the way, then oh glory to God, then we will hear, well done, thou good and faithful servant. Hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Because the seed doesn't matter. Whatever you have done, what happened is what you have done leading up to the last mile of the way. Will you be faithful until the end? Until the very end. Until the very end will you be faithful, because it is the end that will determine your destiny. Praise the name of the Lord. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Glory to his name. Thank you, Sister Richards, for such beautiful selection. And now we come to, time is gone, we come to the part of the open reflections. I know it is impossible to speak about Papa in 2 minutes, but that's what we can allow at this time for whoever come up here. I know everybody would want to have something to say. I would want to say something, but it's just not possible today. So if whatever you are going to say is already said, just stay in your seat and let somebody else say something. Amen. Because we all is not going to get to say something today. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise God. And so we're going to have open reflections, and please limit to each person to 2 minutes. Here we have Monica. Right there.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm here today with a mixed feeling about my grandfather. Oh my God. I feel it to my heart. I remember my grandfather. Yahweh said, Monica, serve God. Yes. Trust God. Believe. God will open doors for you, Monica, you and your children. Yahweh said, you don't have no house for yourself. But God, I'm going to make you get a little home for yourself. And I always come in to look for my grandfather. I always bring him in sure. I always bring him in Malta. Yeah, I always bring in carrot. And I always bring in Irish.
Amen.
And he always say, Monica, God bless you.
Yes.
Rest, Grandpa.
Yes.
Rest in the arms of the angel. Jesus' name, Father. I feel it, Grandfather. I feel it. I don't get to come and see you and say goodbye. But I know that I am your favorite grandchild by mama's side. I know that I am the favorite one. Because when you see Monica come, you know?
Yes.
And she care what you want.
Yes.
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 So I'm here. And I said, do not scatter roses when a person is gone. Give it to the person when he's alive.
Yes.
Yeah, amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Thank you. Amen. Thank you, Monica, granddaughter. Amen. Thank you. Angela, here we come. Not a granddaughter. Amen.
Praise the Lord, church.
Praise the Lord.
I am the first granddaughter from my daughter.
Yes.
Yes. I don't have to boast today. I know he loves me.
Yeah.
I know he loves me, so I don't have to boast. Me and my children, when he's blind and he can't see us, he said, sit out your hand, let me feel how fat you are. You love us.
Yeah.
Don't have to boast. Thank you.
Yeah. Amen. Amen. Thank God. Thank God. Thank you, Angela, granddaughter. Shaitan Spice. You, anyone else? Is there anyone else coming? Okay, so we have sister and sister and our mother coming. Amen. So in the meanwhile, we're gonna have, come on. Reverend Brown, New Testament Church of God, prepared after this one. For selection.
The Savior is waiting to enter your heart. Why did you let him come in? There is nothing in this world to keep me apart. What is your answer to him? Time after time, I was waiting before, and now I don't want waiting again. The Savior willing to open the door, oh, he wants to come in. If you take one step toward the Savior, my friend, you will find his arms open wide. Receive him now, and all of your darkness will end within your heart. He abide. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I am blind, but now I can see.
Yes.
The light of the world, it is Jesus.
Jesus.
Say, I turn on the blood of Jesus. And the devil can do no harm. Say, yes. The blood of Jesus. I know that my Father, today is my birthday. And if my father died today, my birthday. Today was, I am 80 years of it.
My God.
Yes.
Amen.
Thank God.
80.
Thank God. Thank God for Calvary, if I was one done. Thank God. Great change in me. I am so happy. I am so free.
Amen.
Glory. What a friend we had in Jesus.
Amen.
All our sins and grief to bear. What a privilege to carry.
Amen.
Oh God, my Father, today is my birthday, but I know that you rest in the hands of Jesus.
Amen.
Yes, you rest. Oh God, have you saved me, tell you, dear, not to walk alone. You feel his presence near you, and your arms around your children, then your soul of fear no evil. No evil. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you. Thank you for that. Papa's daughter. Amen. My aunt. Amen. Thank God for her. Praise the name of the Lord. And is the New Testament Church of God ready? Okay, we're gonna have Pastor Murray come to us in the name of Jesus. Let's have Pastor Murray.
Amen.
Give a lot of praise, everybody. It's a privilege and honor today to stand in the presence of the Lord. Pastor Taylor, my dearly beloved friend and family, Sister Carly, and all the ministers of the gospel of Christ and families and friends and neighbors, I want to extend my heart of greetings and my sincere heart of condolences to the family and friends. It's one of the toughest thing that somebody could go through, losing a loved one. And as I often say, that there's nothing that can fill that gap. It's a gap that is there And no matter what, nothing can fail it.
Amen.
And for us who are alive, it's our duty to serve the Lord right. It's for us to live the godly life, and knowing that when our times come, we will be with the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
And I know there's a lot of people that are not saved here, but when it comes to the final part, no matter what we possess, no matter what we own, where we've been to, who we are, our family background, our educational background, there's something that is so important when it comes to the final part. What is your total? What is your hand? And I want to let somebody know that this is very serious. Jesus is coming back again. He's coming back again. And as I listen to Pastor Taylor and all his grandson and granddaughter and all the rest of brethren, I could see that he was a ambassador for God. And he has paved the way for everyone. And this evening I'm praying and trusting that somebody will say yes to the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. In Corinthians chapter 15, it said, death is swallowed up in victory. Death, where is your sting? Grave, where is your victory? And I want to let the people know that after death, there is something after death. And when everybody will be standing before our Maker, his name is Jesus Christ. And I'm praying and trusting this evening is not about the big celebration, but it's about somebody say yes to the Lord. Amen. There's one scripture I want to close with you, and it's coming from the book of Revelation chapter 20, verse 15. It says, death and hell was cast into the lake of fire. And whosoever was not found written in the Lamb book of life was cast in the lake of fire. I want the church to understand this. When you can't hear, you're turned on from a visa, from a driver's license, you're taking an education, and you've been turned down from that, there's another hope that you can repeat that test. But let me tell you something. There is coming a day when that book will be opened. And every man will judge out of that book. Hear me, young people. Hear me, young men and young women. Hear me, Papa and Mama. There's nothing people want to hear that your name is not written in that Lamb book of life. Nobody wants to hear that. It's going to be a great disappointment. And I pray this evening that somebody will say yes to the Lord, that your name will be written in the Lamb's book of life. God bless you.
Thank you, Pastor Murray. Amen. Amen. Word of consolation, words of comfort.
Thank you.
Amen. Bless the name of the Lord. And truly, as he said, Papa was an ambassador. And I often think back and said, how Mama handled it. Now we have cell phones. Right? And we can call at any time.
Amen.
But Papa would be in the field working. And they would come to get him to go pray for somebody. Or to go have a street meeting or something. And he would just drop his fork or whatever he's leaving and just go. Mama is home and he just go. And sometimes I wonder, did she worry? Did she fret? Because he didn't have a cell phone to call and said, I'm going so and so and so. There was time, because see, Monica said that she was the best one. I was the best one. Because I used to sleep between them. Papa on one side, Mama on one side, and I'm in the middle. So I'm the best one. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. Yeah. And so there are times when Mama would get up at night and go on the veranda looking for Papa. And when we look, we'll see a little buckle lamp over there. They call Canaan or something like that, coming through the bushes. And Mama would say, bring him home safe, Lord. Bring him home safe, Lord. Bring him home safe, Lord. And he would travel through the night with just a lamp, doing the work of God. What do you call it? The dog. Right. And so that's Papa. He was the peacemaker. They come for him all over the place for peace. He was a problem solver. Family having problem, husband and wife having problem, they come for him. He was everything.
Always giving,
kind and loving. And the distance he was traveling was not no close distance like how we have car to drive now. He was walking. That's an ambassador for Christ. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. New Testament Church?
Yes.
Okay.
Hallelujah. So let's praise the Lord. Let's praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I heard of a city John saw coming down from God out of heaven. The walls are of jasper, the gates are of pearl, and streets are pure gold. He tells of a pure river of life that flows from the throne. And when we have reached that beautiful place, we'll know as we're known. Let's meet by the river, over on that beautiful shore. Let's meet by the river, where love once dwelt, who's gone on before. If you leave there first, just meet by the river. If I leave you here,
back into things, and as he said, and the scriptures tell us, if your name is not written in the Lamb's Book of Life, it's going to be doom for you. It's going to be the lake of fire. And Papa used to sing some songs and preach some message. When you hear those message, you run to the altar. You run to the altar when he preached those message. Not no sweet messages like what's been preaching now. But when they preach about the fire, and when the fire scorch you, and things like that, you run to the altar. And so, as I was thinking back, and all of his children, names was just running through my mind just now. All of them. My mother, my aunts, my uncles. If any of you should lose your soul, this is not Papa's fault. It is not Mama's fault. It is nobody's fault but yours. Because you have been raised in that family. Because, and you have seen the lives that they live. And I remember when Mama died 11 years ago, and as the casket was over on this side, and not looking for Papa to get up and said anything, he was asked, and he got up. And thinking that he would probably break down and things like that. You know what Papa started talking about? That everybody must live good. And then he went to one of his scriptures in Ephesians, talk about husband love your wives, wives love your husband. And this is what Papa was admonishing while his wife was laid in a casket. That's who he is. He loves everyone he comes in contact with. And he wants to see everyone live right. And he wants to see everyone accept Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior. Praise God. And so we're coming down where we're going to have the message of comfort by Bishop Thomas. But before he comes, we're going to have a selection by Sister Melissa Taylor, my beautiful wife, granddaughter-in-law, and the mother of my children. Let's have her in Jesus' name.
Let us worship the Lord. Let us praise the Lord. Let everything that hath breath praise the Lord. Let everything that can move worship the name of the Lord. I'm sure if I go to the cemetery today and I say praise the Lord, I will not hear anything. So let everything that hath breath magnify the name of the Lord. Lift your left hand and worship the Lord. No, lift your right hand and worship the Lord. No, throw both hands in the air and magnify the name of the Lord, because his name is a strong tower today. Blessed be the name of the Lord. You may feel down and feel like God somehow forgotten, that you are faced with circumstances that you can go through. Right now it may seem there's no way out, you're going under. God's proven time and times again, he'll take care of you. He'll do it again for you. He'll do it again. Just take a look at where you are. Oh,
Situations you have, what circumstances you have, but know assured that what he has done before, he can do it again. And he has proven himself over and over and over again, and he'll do it again. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. What a message of comfort, a message of consolation, a promising message that the God will serve will do it again. Praise his holy name. The God who specializes in the impossibility. When it's impossible with man, God knows exactly what to do. And you know the important thing about it is, he knows exactly when to do it. Praise the name of the Lord. He's never late. He's never early. But he's always on time. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise God. 104. His time has come. Never early, never late, but just on time. That's the God we serve. Somebody praise the name of the Lord. Somebody magnify the name of the Lord. Somebody glorify the Lord. Praise his holy name. Glory be to God. We have come this far. Thanks be to God. Glory to God. And now we're going to have the message of comfort from Bishop D.L. Thomas. May you stand on your feet and welcome Bishop Thomas. In the name of Jesus. Give the Lord some praise as he comes.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Amen. Praise God too. Amen. Hello. Taylor, enthusiastic moderator today. We're worshiping God today. Amen. You know, the Bible says when one dies, we should be happy, and somehow we don't seem to be able to get it yet. But we're going to have a touch of it today. Yes. Praise God. And the scripture says, and I want to say some greetings for the bereaved family, all the ministers of the gospel, all who are attending here today. Praise God to pay the last regards. We just welcome and thank God for you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Pastor Murray, get him a message today. It breathe what to show God is at work. The Bible says in Psalms 116 and verse 15, precious in the sight of God is the death of his saints. I feel good when I come to a funeral service like this for a man of God. I can't forget the little song. I have heard him sing quite a few, but the one that stick with me is, what is man? What is man? Man is like a fading flower. In the morning, you're fresh and blue, and the evening, this evening has come. And as I said, the Bible says, precious in the sight of God is the death of his saints. When I thought of what I should say today when I come, it's a scripture that comes to me from St. Matthew chapter 7. When Jesus said, not everyone who said, Lord, Lord, shall enter, but those who do the will. Because many talk and many preach and many rejoice and go on, but Pastor Morris said, make certain your name is on the list. Make certain your name is on the list. It was Pastor Lewis's funeral the first time I made, right in his church, a statement when I said, Pastor Lewis is better than every one of us today. Yes, man, everybody got confused and mixed up. Me say, listen to me now. The Bible talk about blessed are those who die in the Lord. He died in the Lord. Hell of Fagan went in the Lord. He's all right. Me in the Lord right now, what? You don't know if me with backslide. Praise God, somebody. So he's better than me. Even than all of us today. Hallelujah. So precious in the sight of God is the death of the saints. So Jesus gave us a little rundown as Pastor was bringing out, praise God, that when somebody didn't hear their names, they said, Jesus, what's going on? I've been preaching in the name. I cast out devils in the name. Oh, you mean my name is not on the list? Jesus said, yes, you do all of that, but I still don't find the name. I say, thank God, Elder Fagan's name is on the list, because the Bible said, precious in the sight of God is the death of his sins. Hallelujah. And when one died in the Lord, praise God, the Bible said, you rest from the labor. The Bible said, you're gone to sleep. Me no quite understand another one there, God, but me know you can't wake up sleeping person. And the Bible says, there's going to come a time when God will blow one trumpet. Me don't know what kind of trumpet or how it will sound. But my God, if you have died in the Lord, you're going to hear the sound. And you're going to wake up. My God, in the name of Lord Jesus Christ, we are blowing and encouraging folks who have not yet loved and accepted the Lord. Elder Fagan brought you here today to hear this. Praise the Lord Jesus. So make your calling and election sure. In Jesus' name.
Bless the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Short and spicy, right? And to the point. Make your calling and election sure. Praise the name of the Lord. Because when the time comes, we don't want to hear depart from us. But we want to hear, well done, thou good and faithful servant. Thank you, Bishop Thomas, for the words of comfort. Praise his holy name. Glory to God. And at this time is going, we're going to have the eulogy by N. Williamson, grandson. Let's have him.
James Fagan, known as Elder Fagan Papa, was born on January 1st, 1918, to Emmanuel James Fagan and Ella Palmer in Cascade, St. Anne's, Jamaica. He was one of five children. He attended Cascade All-Age School and Bohemia All-Age School. James met and fell in love with Isolyn R. Grant in St. Anne's, Jamaica. They later married April 28, 1946. James was a dedicated husband, father, and farmer. While Isolyn was at home taking care of the children and grandchildren, James was out in the field farming, working hard to ensure that his family was well taken care of. James dedicated his life to Christ in his early 20s. During this time, he attended Revival Zion Church, which was led by his father, Emmanuel. After the death of his father, James led the ministry for approximately 4 years. However, due to illnesses and migration of the members, the ministry was discontinued. James later became a member of the Mount Zion Pentecostal Church, known as the Refuge Temple Apostolic Church in St. Anne's, Jamaica. Approximately a year later, he was ordained as an elder. Elder Fagan, as he was passionately called, was well known through the community as a great and effective preacher. He loved to preach, sing, and prayed frequently. He would travel near and far to visit and pray for the sick and elderly, and to have 10 street meetings services. He was passionate about winning souls for the kingdom of God. he always took time out to pray and encourage others. His words of encouragement always had a lasting impact in the lives of those he touched. Even in his elderly days, James would often take the time to submit himself to fasting and praying, and always spending time in the presence of God. People in the community, both near and far, would often go to James for spiritual guidance. He also did his best to attend to his physical needs. He was known as the problem solver, the peacemaker, the bush doctor, etc. James was so kind and loving. He did not know how to say no when doing good. Everyone loved being in his presence. When he wasn't singing, praying, or encouraging others, he would tell stories to make you laugh. In everything, James gave his all. He faithfully served in the ministry, took care of his family and others, even until death. James fought a good fight. He finished his course, kept the faith, and is now awaiting his crown of righteousness. James Fagan went to sleep peacefully on May 22nd, 22. He is survived by his 9 children, 33 grandchildren, 79 great-grandchildren, 16 great-grandchildren, nieces, nephews, and a host of other relatives and friends. Amen.
Amen. Praise God. And of course, this is just a part, a fraction of his life. I don't think the book they make now could hold if we have to write everything. Amen. But thanks be to God that we can speak the truth about James Fagan without having to pay somebody to speak the truth, without having to pay somebody to cry tears. But his life has touched everyone that has known him and come in his contact. Amen? And he was a prayer warrior. There were times when I used to come home and our friends would say that they stay down at the crossroad and hear Papa praying. They stay down there and hear him praying and singing. That's Papa. And you know what the thing is? Sometimes at night, doesn't matter what time, he's going to pray and he's going to sing. You better try sleep in the noise, but he's not going to stop. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise God. And so that's who he is. He spent his time with God. And there are times when I'm there and I would sneak in the room. It's very hard to sneak in the room without him knowing. But I would sneak in the room and sometimes I'd take the pictures and his hand would be up in the air just praising God and worshiping God and things like that. And he doesn't know I'm there. And I have some pictures of that. And so that's how he was. His life was dedicated to God. And that's an example for us to follow. Amen? Praise the name of the Lord. And as it says in there, that he has fought a good fight. He has finished his course, kept the faith, and now is awaiting his crown of righteousness. Praise the name of the Lord. Praise God. And now we have come where we're going to sing the closing song at this time in the suite by and by. We're going to stand as we sing joyfully and gloriously unto the Lord, after which Elder Taylor will pray the prayer for the bereaved family.
Stand if you can, please. Hallelujah. The family can remain seated. Hallelujah. Let's sing joyfully as we close out. Hallelujah. There's a land that is fairer than death, and by faith we can see it afar. For the Father waits over the way to prepare us a
Jesus. One more, oh God.
Hallelujah.
One more time. Oh God, you have come to the end of this church today.
Hello.
Jesus. Shatakoko Sayamasito Masaya. Oh God. The family Jesus. I'm begging you right now, God, in the name of Jesus. Go through right now, God, to the family. Yes, those that weep, oh God, in the view, guys. Jesus, place them in your hand. Oh God, touch the vein that goes to the body. Mercy to us, the blood Jesus and the bone. Touch the blood, the vein, the giant in the body. Oh God, I believe in Christ. To know, dear God, that the other one has come. But Jesus, you stand to the chin, heart, ear. Oh God, in this world, and you do not sin. Oh God, I mean that God, after God, I pray, Jesus, remember the family. Oh God, they feel it right now. See everyone. Jesus, let the goodness and your mercy, touch them with mercy. Lord Jesus Christ. Lord God, touch Bernadette tomorrow. The very child and glad. And see through before them at will, dear God. Touch them, Jesus, and remember their father. Who is the same and rejoice. Oh God, in your presence, God. It took host, it took Messiah. In the name of Jesus. As together in that carry for you, present you, God. I pray you, Jesus, in the name of Jesus, to protect every soul that comes in this room, inside and outside, God. That you may feel a feeling, mercy, oh, which they never feel before. Oh, God, they take it simple, dear God, but they can feel a feeling from you. Oh, God, which they never feel before. Let them feel it right now, God, to this place again. Oh, when we rest and believe you. That this place can continue to be a saving station. Mama God. Oh, Kosa. Let them feel your prison, God. Jesus. Who touched Pastor Tila? Oh, God. One of his family, especially and pray. He had a task, oh, God, to play as a pastor. I pray, God. I pray in the name of Jesus. Give you wisdom. Oh, God, the portion of your prison, God. Let the understanding, God, that he may feel now he's going. He may feel wisdom going, God, with trust and confidence in your God. Let these people in this present, God, teach them to trust you, Mama God. Teach them to confidence in your God, that they may realize that one day they soon come to an end. Oh, God, that the time so changeable. Jesus, 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 that's changed every time. Oh God, so just at the time, change God, change your mind. Oh God, in this changing time and this changing world, that they may fear in Jesus and try and feel him. Oh God, and when they live in this place, this evening, God going down, are in your home, they feel something rising, oh my God, in your blood, in your vein, in your tongue. This is my prayer. In Jesus' name, Mr. Bishop God, Bishop who? Oh God, take over this place. Jesus, give me the portion. You always do know what to do, God. I only can speak, God, but I'm praying that help in every situation, Mama God Almighty, in every condition, Jesus. Oh God Almighty, this place may be a city station that I may run by refuge. In Jesus' name.
Amen. Thank you, Elder Taylor. God bless you and keep you. Praise the name of the Lord. Thank you. We have come to the end of this part of service. But we want to thank each and every one of you. And even those watching by the various platforms, we thank you for being with us. We thank you for your prayers and support. We thank you for everything you have been doing for the family. And so the family of the late James Fagan wishes to acknowledge with deep appreciation the many expressions of love, concern, and kindness shown to us during this time of bereavement.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. And now we're going to have, I'm going to ask Elder Reed to do the benediction for us. In the name of Jesus. Elder Reed, Jesus' name.
Let us stand at this time, praise the Lord Jesus. And now may the saving grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the of God the Father, full flesh of the Holy Spirit, my divine comforter, rest, remain about us all, now and forevermore. God bless you.
Thank you, Elder. And we'll now have the final viewing as Pamora will take over. All the pallbearers, get yourself ready.
Okay, at the doorway. At the doorway.
At the doorway.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm gonna say goodbye. Oh, I'm gonna say goodbye. When my life on earth is ended, I'll say
Thank you, Jesus.
No change, Papa.
We can go on some more.
It's not the arm.
Whoa, man. Look at girl, you can't go right here, so please. Now try to get a picture. Miss, now try to get a picture right here, so please.
Very peaceful. That is it. Yeah? Come now. Tala, come and heal this. No, let me let stuff drop off by here.
Can we close now?
Can we close now? Can we close now? You, I get. Please go halfway with it for me, and then the pastor will come in. Please. All right. Please don't move. As soon as the pastor comes.
Man that is born of a woman has but a short time to live, and is full of misery. He cometh up, and it's got down like a flower. He fled as it were a shadow and never continued to want stay. In the midst of life we are in debt. Of whom may we succor for all? Yet, O Lord, most holy, O Lord, most mighty, O holy and most merciful Savior, deliver us not within the middle of pain. For knowest, Lord, the secrets of our hearts. Shut not thy merciful ears to our prayers, but spare us, Lord. O God, most mighty, holy, and merciful, the most worthy. Thank you. For as much as it hath pleased Almighty God, His wise providence, to take out of this world the soul of our deceased brother, we therefore commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. O Lord. Looking for the general resurrection in the last day and the life of the world to come, through our Lord Jesus Christ, in whose second coming in glory, majesty, and judge the world. The earth and the sea shall give up their dead, and the corruptible bodies of those who sleep in him shall be changed and made like unto his own glorious body, according to the mighty working whereby he is able to subdue all things to himself. O merciful God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who is the resurrection and the life, in whom whosoever believeth shall live, though he die, and whosoever liveth and believeth in him shall not die eternally. Who also hath taught us by the holy apostle Saint Paul, not to be sorry as men without hope for those who sleep in him. We humbly beseech thee, O Father, to rise us from the death of sin, unto the life of righteousness, that when we shall depart this life, we may rest in him, and that we may be found acceptable in his sight, and receive the beloved fear from thee, saying, come ye blessed children of my Father, receive the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. This we beseech thee in the holy name, our merciful Father, through Jesus, our mediator and redeemer. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and fellowship of the Holy Ghost be with us evermore. Amen. We now go to the hymn sheet while the council get a passage.
Push it down the front. You push it right up. Right up. Pull it tight out, just.
When the trumpet of the Lord shall sound and time shall be no more, and the morning breaks eternal bright and fair, when the saved and heard shall gather over on the other shore, and the road is called up yonder happy hill, when the road is called up yonder, when the road is called up when the road is far up yonder, when the road is far up yonder, I'll be there. I'm right back on this morning. Of all his wondrous love and care, then all of life is over. The work on earth is done, and the road is called up yonder.
The road is called up yonder, when the road is called up yonder, when the road is called up yonder, when the road.
It's called up yonder, when the road is called up yonder, when the road is called up yonder, shall we gather at the reaping, where bright angels' feet have trod, with his Christian tide forever, from the throne of God. Yes, we will
gather at the river, beautiful, beautiful river, gather with the saints of the river that flows from the Jordan.
On the morning of the river, washing up a silver spray.
Washing up a silver
We will walk and worship ever.
We will walk and worship ever.
All the happy golden days. Yes, we will gather at the river,
gather with the saints at the river that flows by the throne of God.
As I journey through this land, for I came more close to him, he will give me land. Satan's intellectual soul turn my thoughts aside. But my Lord goes ahead. Meet me by the river someday. Meet me by the river. Lord, saints of God, this is as far as we can go with Elder Fagan this afternoon. So we're going to sing Sleep On, Beloved.
Sleep and take your rest. Lay down your head upon the Savior's breast. We love you, Lord Jesus, love you best. Good night.
God bless you, everybody.